Gabby from EDHewS, your co-host.
Oh yeah, Gabby! Come on, the movie's just about to start!
Movie night!
Are you ready?
Over the hills and far away, Teletubbies come to play.
Oh my gosh! Grant, turn it off!
Grant, why would you show me that?
Gosh, Gabby, what do you want to watch then? I did not think it was going to be that scary.
That was so messed up.
Calm down.
It's not even Halloween yet.
It's almost Halloween.
That was scary.
Almost
you know
Halloween.
I don't like scary movies.
Gabby, please. What was that? Should we answer?
I'm not trying to die tonight. Go answer it yourself.
Package for the Gordons?
Okay.
We need to get the EDHewS right now, Grant. This is not a joke.
Good morning, Miners.
I'm Gabby.
I'm Grant.
And this is EDHewS.
Halloween edition.
I'm a kissy face emoji.
I'm a banana.
Gabby, we never found out who wrote that letter.
Oh my gosh, who do you think it was?
I think it was Allie and Spencer in EDHewS News.
Yep, I think so too. Let's check it out.
Even scary. Why would you
I scared you. I got you.
You pick me the stupid costume and then you do that to me.
I got you. Okay, well if that didn't scare you, then maybe we should get on to a spooky EDHewS News.
Fine.
CSF Red Ribbon Week is this week, October 24th through the 28th. Red ribbons will be handed out every morning before school. Don't forget to wear your red ribbon to show your commitment to being drug-free.
CSF is selling boograms for only $1. Send someone you care about a boogram and brighten, not frighten, their day.
Miss Bitney's homeroom has once again challenged all other homerooms to a pumpkin decorating contest. Don't forget to drop your change in the pumpkin that you wish to vote for this Friday at lunch. All proceeds will go to the EB Foundation.
CSF is collecting new toys to donate to the Child Welfare Service. If you're interested in helping, you can donate to room 605 on December 1st. All right, guys, hope you have an amazing Halloween.
And I hope you guys pick a spookier outfit than Spencer.
You picked this for me.
I know. Well, Miners, have a great week.
You said I look good.
So, Gabby, it wasn't Allie or Spencer. We've got that covered.
Got it covered. But can we just talk about how exhausting it is to do sports in these costumes?
Do sports, let alone walk around. I slip on my banana all the time.
I totally get you. So why don't we check out Josh Nelson to see what sports has for us this week.
Good morning, Myers. Welcome back to EDHewS Sports.
You know, Josh, it's Halloween time, and it's the scariest time of the year.
But you know what's really scary?
No, what is it?
It's our football team. Just ask Redwood.
Let's check out the highlights.
The varsity football team took on Redwood last Friday in an exciting match. Unfortunately, the Rangers drew first blood with an early touchdown from the kickoff return. But the Miners immediately responded with a pass from Boswell to Hernandez to equalize the score. The Miners' defense had an incredible showing, completely shutting out the Rangers' offense. So how'd you feel about the student section on Friday? Dude, honestly, the student section was so lit the entire game. Shout out to the Miners for having that Miner pride. The Miners won with a score of 19-9. Their next game is against Lemoore this Friday. Make sure to come and support our school.
The girls' volleyball team suffered a disappointing loss against Redwood with a score of 1-3 in a best of 5. Hey, what's your favorite part about volleyball?
I think my favorite part is honestly the hype around it. You know, the students, the coaches getting angry, like Clyburn breaking the clipboard. It's just every part of it, you know? It's a Lady Miners Senior Night, so make sure to go out and show your support at home tonight.
Unfortunately, the water polo boys lost 8-7 against Redwood.
It was a very close match with both sides going back and forth, but Redwood barely edged out the win.
It's also water polo senior night, so make sure to go show your support to them.
That's all we have for you today, Miners.
Be sure you go check out our volleyball and water polo teams tonight because they're scary good. Wait, where are you going? I guess we'll see you next week, Miners. Gabby, this suit smells terrible.
Yeah, I've worn it every football game since last battle, and I haven't washed it since.
Oh my gosh, okay. Well, I applaud you. At least you got some Miner spirit going on.
You got that right. Why don't we check out Green Sea Network, see what they have for us this week. Grant, I cannot get over the fact that you made me watch such a scary movie at our sleepover.
Oh my gosh, Gabby, again? I mean, come on, they're the Teletubbies. Like, I didn't think it was that scary.
Have you seen Entertainment?
No, have you?
Yeah, and it's pretty spooky.
Okay, well then let's take a look.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, Gabby, look, Katy Perry,
stop!
Oh, you scared me. I wanna get your face on replay.
Then let's check out replay for this week.
Hey Miners, it's Giancarlo with Replay It, put on by your book. Congratulations to Kelly Baldwin for winning the theme Harvest. Go to 603 with Mr. Jirocki to claim your prize. And here are your options for the end of summer theme. Option one and option two. Again, it's option one and option two. This week's theme is fall. What's your favorite part of fall? Pumpkin spice lattes, the weather under 100 degrees, or just simply getting ready for winter? Show us. Make sure to have these pictures uploaded by 5th period on Monday. That's it for now, Miners. See you later.
So Grant, what's it like being a banana?
Being a banana has its perks. It's actually very appealing.
Wow, that's deep.
You know what else is deep? Creative company.
Let's check it out.
I cannot even imagine where I would be today were it not for the handful of friends who have given me a heart full of joy. This quote, said by Charles R. Swindoll, is actually very true. Friendship is something that is often taken for granted. However, once in the presence of true friends, you feel elated to be alive. Be grateful for the people you have around you, because even when you graduate, the memories you have of the past will guide you through the future. These friends you have now, believe it or not, will be there at the most pivotal moments of your life. Don't take the people in your life for granted. They're all important, and so are you. If I were to be given a choice, I would spend all of my time with my friends because that's when I'm happiest. And that doesn't have to be the case for everyone. Do what makes you happy, whether it's spending time with your loved ones, your family, your friends, doing trivial things such as carving pumpkins or just spending random time with each other, talking. Living in the present is so important because, yeah, the future is important, but you're not really going to get to that future if you don't live in the present. Just take life in stride. It may seem boring, but in the end, that's what really matters, is spending quality time with quality people.
So Gabby, what do you like to do on Halloween?
Oh, Halloween. I love to sit around the campfire and listen to scary Halloween stories.
Tell me more.
Let's check it out with Quick and Chandler on our scary Halloween segment.
So guys, you hear about the mimes going around attacking people lately?
Pretty sure they're clowns, Kevin.
I'm like 100% sure it's mimes. You know the guys you can't hear with like the boxes and stuff?
They can't talk.
Clowns can talk. Clowns have big shoes. So anyways, mimes.
Kevin, they're clowns.
Kevin, when was the last time you saw a mime trying to scare someone?
I saw it on Fox News.
Foxes have news?
Yeah, where there was this dude in a bunch of makeup blowing balloon animals up. It was super scary.
Kevin, that's literally a clown.
Yeah, but he didn't actually have a balloon. He was just miming it.
Chubby bunny.
Okay, we can stop talking about mimes.
Wild.
Let's do what we came here to do. Scary stories.
So once upon a time, there were four kids.
Sitting around a campfire.
On a night just like tonight.
And one of the boys really loved marshmallows.
And this would be fine on a normal night.
But this was not a normal night. The marshmallow murderer just escaped from prison.
Guys, this is scary.
And so he found his victim, the boy who loved marshmallows.
So he hops the fence.
And walks toward his victim.
Then he starts crawling towards him.
And then he attacks!
Yeah, there's no such thing as a marshmallow murderer.
Guess what the next segment is, Gabby?
What?
What's up? Wow, Gabby, that costume just fits you so well. It just gives you such a nice circular figure.
Say no more. Let's check our random acts of kindness with Macy.
Hey, Miners, welcome back to Random Acts of Kindness. Let's get started.
One kind word can change someone's day. You don't need a reason to help people. Be the person that makes others feel special.
Keep smiling because life is a beautiful thing and there's so much to smile about. Make someone smile whenever you can. You never know how much of a difference you could be making in their life at that moment. Smile because it's good for you. Making one person smile can change the world. Maybe not the whole world, but their world. Keep smiling no matter what.
We are perfect the way we are.
You are love.
You are beautiful the way you are.
Believe in yourself.
Well, that's it for this show. Have a happy Halloween, Miners.
Grant, what are you doing this spooky weekend?
Well, this spooky weekend, most of my friends are in the drama show. So I will be in the LD theater this weekend.
Oh, let's check out the drama segment this week.
My name is Tristan Brooks. My role in drama is the class president. The drama show is about the secondaries in the beginning. And then we go to our first one act, which is perfect. It's about a girl who was told her whole life is perfect, and then she goes through changes and she starts to move away from being perfect. And we have more secondaries again. And then our last one act is prom perfection, which is about prom and just all the issues or good things about prom. The first show is October 28th at 7 o'clock, and then on October 29th there's a show at 2 o'clock and a show at 7. For students, it's $6 and adults, it's $8. It will be at the El Diamante Theater.
Grant, I heard you were an amazing writer.
From who? My mom?
Maybe more of a creative writer?
I still don't know what you're talking about.
Let's just check out creative writing and see what they have for us this week.
Hey Miners, my name is Maddie McLean and I'm president of the Creative Writing Club here on campus. Do you have that novel that needs to be written, or that song in your head? Well, you're in luck, because this upcoming month of November is National Novel Writing Month. Come stop by 6:03 on Thursday at lunch to get started on your 50,000 words.
Well, happy Halloween, Miners.
Have a great weekend.
Be safe.
Don't eat candy off the floor.
Be sure to brush your teeth after all that candy.
Have a great weekend, Miners. See you next Wednesday.